whenever a new compound or a potential new medicine comes into clinical trials, it's always first tested preclinically. So it's really essential that we have good animal models, but also that we evaluate them in the right way so that any results we get from preclinical drug trials are translatable towards clinical trials and that we don't waste too much money afterwards for drugs that that don't do what we want them to do in a clinical trial. So that's really essential. And non-invasive imaging and micro-CT can really help us in a way to very well quantify what's happening in, for instance, a mouse model. So, for instance, for lung diseases and lung fibrosis, there's long been a translational problem in the sense that all of the preclinical drugs that were working in a mouse model of fibrosis, afterwards they all failed in clinical trials. And we think one of the problems could be in the methodology, that when you look with ex vivo methods such as histology and histochemical methods, they're good, but we're missing dynamic information and we're also missing what's actually happening in the lungs. And with micro-CT, we could actually show that when you can really quantify the amount of fibrosis and also the compensation that the mouse does in terms of enlarging air spaces to be able to keep breathing when lung fibrosis is there, that we can much more accurately monitor whether drugs are really working in the mouse or not before they go to clinical trials. So for research, we're very much technology dependent, and technology development has focused for micro-CT a lot on increasing the resolution so that we would be able to scan a mouse, which is about 1,000 times smaller than a human patient, with micro-CT, for instance. But then in the next step, now that we can have fantastic small images from an animal as small as a mouse, it's also important to focus on dose, for instance, so that the radiation dose is so small, but that we can still have images with a high enough quality so that we can really repeatedly image an animal and that it does not suffer from any of the radiation that is involved in this imaging process. And that's a really important development that is going on now. And in the future, I foresee, because this development is going on now, algorithms are developed to improve this even further so that we will have even better images at much lower dose that will allow us to quantify even more things up to small airways in vivo, and that would be something that would be really cool in the future.